Hey everybody and welcome back to some more Planet Coaster. Last episode we started out with the first mission in the career mode, that being this one over here, Pirate Battle inside of Captain Lockjaw's Buried Treasure. Since the end of last episode, the game has fully released. It's now out to the public if you'd like to go buy it. But they also unlocked a bunch of extra stuff within the game that wasn't available in the beta version that I was playing before. For example, these two missions here, the Creature Awakens and Pirate Grove missions within the Captain Lockjaw's Buried Treasure kind of campaign section. These were both locked off and weren't available in the beta version, but are now available in the full release of the game. And so, without further ado, we are going to start a brand new scenario and see what Creature Awakens has in store for us and see if we can complete all the challenges, because hopefully, I'd like to get gold again. So here we go, Creature Awakens, rumors of engineers meeting sticky ends scared off the park staff, leading to a recent sale. The bargain price presented an irresistible opportunity, so hire new staff, complete the construction of the park, and ignore the strange noises underground. I'm sure it's nothing to worry about. Alright, so we have ourselves our three kind of main objectives over here. Easy, medium, and hard. Easy, hire two janitors and build two rides. That is fairly easy. Medium, hire two mechanics and build five rides. And then hard is hire two entertainers and attract 1,000 guests into the park. Right now, we've got 336 guests in the park. And just like I did last episode, I'm going to quickly bump up the UI here a little bit just to make it a little easier for everyone to see what is going on. Hopefully that doesn't mess with my controls. Sometimes it does, but it looks like that's fine. So, we've got this really ominous looking hole in the middle of our park here. I'm not a massive fan of this. It looks a little scary. These are props that you can place down, but within this scenario, we can't actually move them. You'll see it says this item is locked. And also, one thing that is really cool about this park, we've got this track that goes inside or like under the ground here, goes in the floor. And one feature that I didn't show off last episode was the ability to actually ride the ride. So what we can do here is we can go into the seat mode. We can go into like the first person camera mode here, and we can actually ride all of the roller coasters in the park and see what it would be like to actually ride these rides. I'm going to speed things up a little bit here just because otherwise it would take us like 6 minutes just to sit through this entire ride, because this one is actually really, really long. So this is where it starts out. It looks really nice. I like what they've done with kind of the building blocks here. Within the game, these aren't really placeable. You can build this kind of stuff, this kind of station that they've built here, but they don't come pre-made. What the team who made the game have done is they've got all of the little building blocks in the game and made some really cool looking stuff. Like all this stuff here is makeable, but it would take an extreme amount of time to get a park that looked like this. But the ride is really nice. It looks pretty cool. And it looks kind of fun. It's a fairly long ride, but not too long, which I guess is good. I think we're about to come up. Yeah, this is the place where we got off last time. So you know what? I'm going to exit here, and we're going to back out a little bit. So let's go take a look. This ride is actually packed. People are queuing out the wazoo to get on this ride. What is going on with the Kraken's Lair? All right, let's see. The queue is full for the Kraken's Lair. 40% of people are a little bit annoyed at that. I want to go on the Kraken's Lair. 32% of people are pretty happy. It looks like for the most part, people are liking it. How much are we charging people to get on this ride? $24. That is actually insane. That is a ridiculous amount of money to pay for a ride. Nausea is in the green, which is good. So here we go. I didn't mention this last time either, but there were three different like factors to a roller coaster: excitement, fear, and nausea. Nausea you want as low as possible. Fear you want to be in the middle here. You want to be in this green spot, and then excitement you want as close to, I think it's 12 is the maximum you can get. But you basically want them in the green zone for each one. This one is doing all right. Nausea's right down there on the low side. It's not making anybody nauseous for the most part. Excitement and fear are not really there. The excitement's not too high, but people seem to love it. People are actually queuing for, in my opinion, way too long to pay $24 to ride this ride. But one thing that we can do, first of all, you know what, I'm going to pause the game and we're going to try and complete some of these first objectives. So hire two janitors is definitely something that we can do right away. So let me get rid of all of this. I'm going to go to park management and let's go to staff. Let's grab ourselves a janitor. And you know what, we'll also probably grab a mechanic while we're at it as well, just in case the moneymaker breaks down, because right now this is the only thing that is making us money. This is the only ride that this park has. Nothing else is here. We've got one little house in the distance, which is selling the priority passes, which is allowing people to kind of skip the queue a little bit and go down this little ramp if they want to pay. I think it's like $5. Let's have a look here. They're paying $5 for a priority pass, which, how are people feeling about that? Let's see. Priority pass looks busy. I'll try some other time. This priority pass isn't worth that much to me. All right. I guess that's fair. They're paying $5 to then pay an extra $24 to ride this ride, which is not a great value for money. I will admit, priority pass that works on one roller coaster is not fantastic. I think we needed two janitors in order to complete the quest there. So we'll go ahead and play that. And that should get that ticked off, and it has. And I guess we could focus on getting two rides built, but I kind of want to try and get this line moving a little bit faster here because it is packed and we are turning people away. People are leaving the park because of the fact that this thing's full. So you know what? Actually, no, I'm going to pause here real quick. Before we look at getting this ride kind of moving a bit quicker, one thing we will do here is we'll go to rides and we'll build a nice cheap ride like the Whirly Rig right here. We'll put it right there in the middle so that when people do get turned away from here because the queue is full, they're going to turn around and they're going to be like, hey, I should probably go on the Whirly Rig, which I now notice is facing completely the wrong way around. So if we press X, we can actually go and we can rotate this. Let's go ahead and make it face this way. I think that might be a little bit more appealing to people wanting to get on the ride. I will turn off the angle snap here because I want it to just be there. Beautiful. All right. I didn't realize how much that was going to kind of embed itself into the hill. I thought it looked like flat land from over here, but that's fine. Let's put down our park entrance. Do I want to put it down like, I want the queue to be fairly long, but I'm thinking about where I want the exit to be. Do I want the exit to be, okay. What I'm going to do, I'm going to put the entrance like kind of round here, and I'm going to put the exit if I can kind of over here. Can I build a path from that exit or not? Also, what? Are we using this one? That looks about right. I think we can terraform, if I'm not mistaken. But the question is, oh, it's here, terrain. Oh, we can't do that. We have to unlock terrain. In that case, that is going to make that exit pretty much impossible there. So let's move the exit to, I guess, like right here, maybe. Can we put a path down there? We can. So I want this to kind of come up and around. Maybe not quite as long as 5. Let's bring it out. And then I kind of want it to come around like this. So I want it to connect up, if possible. Oh, here we go. I want it to connect up, if possible, over here by the entrance. Can I get that? I saw it. I saw it. There it is. Boom. I want people to walk out and be directly in front of the entrance to our big main roller coaster here. So that when they get off that, they're more likely to go and try and queue up for this thing if there is a queue available, which we'll work on in just a second. As for the normal queue, let's go ahead and connect up this to the path. I don't necessarily think that it needs to be a massive queue just yet. And actually, it's kind of hard to build this thing on the area that we've actually set it up here. So you know what? I'm just going to do something like, oh, come on now. It's not going to work. Can I do like, where can I hook this up? I don't want it to be too long, mostly because of the fact that this is a horrible place to put down a path. It's really not working out too well whatsoever. Can we just connect this up? Is that higher up? It might be, oh no, that's going over now. Okay, why can I not get this to connect? You know what? That'll do. That will do. We completed the bronze objectives. That was actually super easy. So we'll hit continue here. This looks a little horrible, I'm not going to lie, but this is kind of the only flat area of land where the path that's already built is like actually flat. Over here, it's kind of hard to connect to the path that's already raised. It's a bit of a pain. So we'll put that there. We will open the ride for business. And you know what? Right away, we're going to charge $6.50 to get on this ride. I think that's fair enough. So we'll hit play. Hopefully a couple of people will start to get on that ride. No one wants to pay $6.50. All right, fine. I guess in that case, we will lower the price to $5. $5, that is a bargain price. There we go. People are willing to pay $5. And you know what? We could probably get a priority pass going on here pretty quickly. We'll enable the priority pass. We'll put the entrance like right, oh, can I not put it on this? Oh, there we go. We'll put it like right there. We'll put the exit like right there, and then we'll connect this up, hopefully increasing the value or the perceived value of our current priority pass. That was actually much easier than the initial path that we put down there, but hopefully that will make people a little bit more willing to pay the $5 to get this priority pass here. But look at that. Boom, the first people on the ride, priority pass holders. Fantastic. All right, but we'll also we'll make it so that they have high priority. We'll try and encourage priority passes a little bit here. Now, as for this card, before we start looking at the bronze objectives or the silver objectives, this right here is taking way too long. There are far too many people in the queue, and it's not moving fast enough. So one thing we could do is increase either the speed here. You can increase the train speed, or we can increase the number of cars. Unfortunately, you can't increase the number of cars while the ride is open. So what we are going to have to do here is stop the ride, and then bump the number of cars up. How many can we have? Whoa, 20? Wow. I thought we were going to be able to have like 12, but 20 is actually crazy. So I guess that's fine. We do have to test this. And one thing that is going to slow us down here is departure interval. And that's how many seconds after one car goes before the next car goes. Right now it's set to 35 seconds. If we leave it like that, that means that it's going to take like 10 minutes before all of the cars set off and get back around, because we've just added 20 carts to the ride. So you know what? I'm going to make that like 1 second. And hopefully that will be okay. We do have to test it. Unfortunately, we can't just turn it on. So here we go. We now have 20 carts all available to hold people, and we're setting every car off 1 second after the previous car. We do have to wait for the first car to get all the way back, and until that time, people are actually going to start to walk away. Hopefully, everyone's actually leaving. Everybody's leaving the park. Right now, we've got 285. I think we had like 400 people when the park opened. I'm kind of hoping that they're leaving very, very quickly. Hopefully, this will hurry up. All the cars are gone. We're just waiting for the first one to get back. Hopefully, it'll be back before the last person leaves the queue here, so they can just turn around and get right back on the car. Even if they do all leave, I'm hoping that once this comes back online, it will start to draw people back. Oh, look, here it is, here it is, here it is. Can we get it before this guy leaves? Can I open it up before the last person leaves the queue? That is the question. I'm waiting for this to turn green. Oh, I can't do it. He just got out. That's all right. He's going to turn right back around and get on it. Come on, you just left. It's now, it's open again. It's open. It's open. You can come back out, but you can come back on the ride. Oh, here we go. Look at this. People are already turning back around. People are like, I heard the ride's open again. Yeah, okay. So hopefully, oh my goodness, look at this. This is horrifying. But hopefully everyone gets back and gets on the ride again, because it is now, it's moving faster than ever. It's moving super quick. We could probably also reduce the ticket price at this point as well to like maybe $20. If people are willing to pay $24, I guess we should probably leave it at $24. But my hope is that we can get more and more people onto this ride, maybe more and more people into the park if we charge $20 over $24. People are coming back. Look at this. People are coming back in flocks. I love it. All right. We did just get a little bit of a notification telling me that people are thirsty. So we should probably look into getting some shops and facilities into the park as well. So let's see here. Where do I want to put these? I'm thinking like maybe right here, kind of in between the entrance to this ride and the exit of this ride, like right here. Everyone kind of has to walk past this area. If you're getting off this roller coaster, you have to come up and around. So I think having them right about here would be perfect if we can get them to sit nicely. Now, I am going to build these kind of like default bland ones just because they're quite a bit cheaper than the fancy pre-built ones over here. So let's grab a cosmic cow milkshake and let's see about putting this thing down. So we press X, we can then go ahead and lift it up. And we can also rotate it a little bit like that. And I want to fit a couple of shops in here. So let's move this along just a little bit. And then do we want to move it down a bit as well? I kind of want it to be on level with... Yeah, there we go. Okay, let's rotate it a little... Oh, I didn't want to put it there. It's on a bit of an angle. Can we move this? We can. Hold on. Hold on. Let me... Can I actually move this? Because pressing X isn't doing anything now. All right, well, I guess it's going to be on a bit of an angle. That is fine. Let's also throw down a good old-fashioned Chief Beef. We'll bring it all the way up. Give it a bit of a rotation here. Rotate it towards the stairs. There we go. Bring it down just a smidge. What happened there with the rotation? There we go. I don't want it too far up. Boom. That will do. It's... Oh, my goodness. Look at this. It is on a bit of an incline. This is... Like, physically, this is actually impossible, but for now, I guess it will work just fine. All right, so we've got a Chief Beef, and we've got a Cosmic Cow Milkshake. Hopefully, that'll take care of people being hungry and thirsty before or after they get on any of our rides here. What is the next objective under medium? So we need to hire one more mechanic and build 5 rides. Right now, we are actually making a ton of money. A second ago, we were on $5,000. Now, since just in the time it took me to build these and get everyone back into the park, we're now on over $9,000. And so I think we should be able to quite handily afford a second mechanic here, like so. And I guess now we need to build 2 more rides. I kind of want to start building in this big old open circular area over here and get people kind of over to this monstrosity that is in the ground, whatever the heck that is. So you know what? Let's go to rides again, and let's look at getting the forge. I'm thinking I want to build the forge, like, smack bang in the center, directly over this, like, horrific monstrosity that is in the ground. So let's see here. Can we get this perfectly kind of centered on top of this hole? I think we can. We can do something like that, maybe? Is that kind of centered nicely? It is. Perfect. All right. So I'll go ahead and I'll tick that off. We can place that there. And again, this one looks like it might be a little bit more popular. So we'll put down like an entrance over here, I guess. Yeah, I guess we can do something like that. And then we'll put down an exit like right about there. We'll make the exit nice and short. The exit is going to take you right back over to the beginning of here. Is this... Did we build the right path before, or is it this one? I think it's this one. So we'll try and build this out towards the exit here. This does have to kind of come up a little bit. There we go. It's a little jarring going up that bit there, but that should be fine. And then over on this side, we made $5,000 that month. That is actually crazy. And then round on this side, we'll do the exact same thing, and we'll try and bend this round a little bit. So I have been playing a little bit of this game, single player, kind of in the challenge mode, and trying to build circles in this game is actually horrible. It's kind of hard to get a perfect circle going, but that looks like it might work pretty well. We are using the wrong path here by the looks of things. Yeah, it looks like we're supposed to be using this one. Oh, I can upgrade these individually. That is actually awesome. All right, let's undo that because I don't want that little like connection there popping out, but we can go and spend a couple of dollars fixing that up there. We'll continue this round to make a full circle in a second. For now, I do want to just put down the entrance here and get people onto this ride so we can try and make a little bit more money from this one as well. Now, I do quite like using the kind of square grid here when I'm building these paths, but given the nature of this, like, ride, the fact that it's circular and it's in a massive circle, I don't necessarily think that those square edges are going to work too well. So you know what? I'm going to kind of hug the wall a little bit here in terms of this ride. Let's have that go right to there. Then let's extend a little bit and see about having it kind of go all the way around like so. And then we'll kind of try and loop back a little bit. I don't want it to loop so wide. I kind of want it to just loop just... Oh, can we do it with the grid? Can I do... No, let's do this, I guess. It's not the best corner in the world. I will be the first to admit that, but we'll do something like that, and then we'll lower the length a little bit, and we'll do something. You know what? We'll bring it out. We'll do this here, and then... Oh, we gotta go up. Okay, let's go up, and then down to a flat level. And I mean, sure. Look at this. That is actually horrific. What? I don't know how people are going to feel about this. The scenery rating is 95%. I think people are going to be fine with queuing in this just because of how insane these tentacles are down here. So hopefully that'll draw people. Yeah, look at this. People are already on the way round to this area of the park. That is fantastic. Now, all we need to do is build 3 more rides. We need to build 3 more rides, hire 2 entertainers, and get 1,000 guests. I don't think that hiring entertainers is going to be all that hard. It is going to be a little bit expensive, but you know what? We'll get a Cosmic Cow to stand right outside Cosmic Cow Milkshakes. Can we get him to like stand right here? Let's see, employment, free roaming. No, I want you to work roster. I want you to, well, if we create a new work roster and we select Cosmic Cow Milkshakes and then save the work roster, I think what we can do is we can go ahead and we can assign him to my new roster, which I should probably name to an actual thing. Let's see here, staff roster. Let's rename this to, how do I rename this? Sorry, it's here. We'll call this Cosmic Cow Staff. That'll do, and we'll save the work roster. And I think now, if we were to go ahead and assign him to Cosmic Cow Staff, he should kind of just hang around outside of Cosmic Cow Milkshakes. Yeah, look at that. Hopefully, he'll also kind of increase the happiness of people who are riding the Kraken's lair as well. How is this doing, by the way? It looks like it's doing pretty well. The queue's gone down massively. It looks like less people are riding it, but I think that's just because we've managed to get so many people riding it one at any given time. We've managed to get the queue right down and hopefully get people onto other rides quicker and maybe make a little bit more money in the process as well, which we are doing. We're almost back up to 10,000 again, which is just crazy. Also, this ride does seem to be proving pretty popular. Not necessarily extremely so. We should probably actually get some bins down because I see a lot of litter and the janitors are doing quite a bit of work. So you know what? Scenery, let's go to park or path extras and let's throw down a couple of bins here. Let's put down, I guess, like one right here between Cosmic Can Milkshake and Chief Beef. And you know what? We'll put one like there and there as well. Hopefully that doesn't cause too much kind of congestion as people try and walk through. As for these park benches, you know, you might want to watch your kid be on the Whirly Rig one. So you know what? We'll put down like one here, because I can't seem to put it anywhere else. One there, and then here, and here. Beautiful. Can we put down some over here? Not really. I don't like putting them on the paths, just because it blocks things up a little too much. And there's not really anywhere I can put them off the path, because all the paths are floating here. So I guess that'll do for now. We could put a bin at the exit to this ride, if we put one kind of there and there. Hopefully, that'll stop people from doing stuff like this, where they just litter as soon as they get off the ride. And if it's a particularly nauseating ride, people do often kind of vomit as soon as they get off as well, which is not great. And it's something that you can kind of mitigate a little bit by putting down trash cans nearby as well. So we've got this thing up and running. Now, in hindsight, we could probably have fit a couple of rides into here instead of just the one. But you know what? We'll put down a few more. I guess, I was going to say over here. I was going to say like over here a little bit. But I don't know. You know what? Yeah, sure. Let's put down the kickflip. The kickflip. Actually, no. Let's put down Rocktopus. We're going to put down Rocktopus over here. We're going to make this area like a kid-friendly area. So if you want to bring your kids, if you're a family, you can hang out in this area. If you're like an adult or a teenager, you can come over to the just death pit that is Forge 2. That looks horrifying and is over this massive void with tentacles that have been known to kill people, which is just fantastic. So you know what, we'll set this Rocktopus up over here, and then we'll throw down another entrance, like right. Don't want to put it like right there? Yeah, I'll put that right there, and then I'll put the exit down. Again, I want to put it over here, but that's going to involve quite a walk. You know what, let's put it like right there. Then can I kind of loop around a little bit? Can I come off here? Oh, look at this. Oh gosh, what is this? I don't want this to be quite so long, so I want it to come up a little bit. Now we can make it longer again, so it comes round and round and almost round again. Let's make it a bit shorter. Can we hook this up? We can. Beautiful. All right. And then let's quickly also go ahead and upgrade all of these to the correct paths, because we just completely built the wrong ones last time. So there we go. Now everyone who finishes Rocktopus can get background into the main area here. I kind of want to funnel people towards other rides and towards like our shops and facilities over here. So that should work out just fine. And then let's go ahead and then let's do, I guess, something like this. Again, as horrible as it is, we'll shorten that a little bit and see about connecting it kind of just about there. That'll do. Let's get rid of this bench, or let's at least move it. This is a bit of a weird area. You've got like two rides just opposite each other. These guys are going to be fighting. They're going to have like a fierce competition going at all times to see who can sell the most tickets. Nobody is wanting to go on Rocktopus. How much are we? Oh, it's off. That's why. Let's go ahead and turn that on. And you know what? Make that $5 as well, just to make the battle between these two here a little bit fairer. You know, both their rides cost $5. Rocktopus is a little bit bigger, but we'll see how that plays out. How are we doing on park scenery? Not great. The queue rating is 20% and then 32%. So we should probably look into fitting something in the middle here. Let's see. If we go to blueprints, what if we've kind of got a bit of a Kraken theme going, but I don't know what that... Does that fit with pirate, I guess? Do you want to put like some rocks? Maybe like a boat thing going like here? A crash-landed boat? How does that affect the scenery? 52%? 37%? I guess that works. Then, you know, we'll have some pirates from this area kind of shooting over, and then over here we'll have like more pirates. Yeah, look at this. Shooting back. Oh, beautiful. That, if that doesn't increase the scenery rating, 90%, look at that. And then 90%. That is actually fantastic. I would stand in this queue. Look at this. Look at this. You got these guys in the funky hats wearing red, shooting over at these guys in the funky hats wearing whatever color they like, because they're just rebels. Oh, it's beautiful. They're fighting over the ship. This bounty that has been left on this rock. Oh, it's fantastic. All right, so we've got that going. We only need to build one more ride to get us up to 5 rides, hire one more entertainer, and then get our park, our monthly park guests up to 1,000. We need to get 1,000 people into the park. So you know what? Let's go over to park management. Let's grab staff. I want to hire a new entertainer. And you know what? We might as well get Captain Lockjaw himself over here. He's going to stand right here, and we're going to create a brand new work roster because he's going to be... I like putting him onto the whirly rig, but really he's just going to stand here between both of these, hopefully. So let's see. Work roster. Let's create a new one. Let's call it, for now, just like Pirates, I guess. Sure, I guess Pirates will work. And you know what? We'll select this ride and this ride. We'll select both of those. Save work roster. Hopefully that will kind of just keep him here. If I put that there, does that just kind of keep him in this area? No, he's going away. Maybe he's going to stand by the exit of those rides? I have no idea, but that's fine. That's gone ahead and completed another objective of the hard section there. So now we need one more ride, and we need to attract about 200-ish more people to the park. One thing I think we're probably missing here is some kind of toilet in facilities. We don't have any toilets whatsoever just yet. So you know what? Let's go ahead and do something like this. Again, we'll press X, bring that up, rotate it around just a little bit, and see if we can. That's a bit of a... actually, it's a bit of a horrible place to put that. So you know what? Let's cancel that. And let's instead put the toilets like just over here. We're going to put it right here. So as you enter the park, or as you're heading towards the priority pass section, and we'll move this bench here, which is just causing a huge issue. We'll move that maybe to like here? Sure, why not? Move that there. And as soon as you come into the park, if you want to go to the toilet, you've got to kind of take a look at the priority pass area. You've got to see what the priority pass has to offer. And look at that, just in time, many guests need the toilet. That is fine because we have got good news for all of those who need the toilet. We got a brand new toilet and it is free because I'm not about charging for the toilet. At least not yet, at least. You know, we're doing pretty well. We're on 17,000, which is crazy. People are still queuing up for this ride and I guess loving it. Forge 2 was really good value. The queue for Forge 2 was good. I want to go on Forge 2. Fantastic. You know what? $10. The price is going up. People like it. The price is getting hiked. All right. What should be the final ride that we put down? We could do a little bit of research if we wanted to. And see about researching a new ride. Yeah, you know what? Let's do a thrill ride. We'll pump $1,500 a month into it because we've got the money to spend. And we'll see how that does. We'll see what that gives us. And we'll see if we can put that down in our park somewhere. And make our park just a little bit better. Because we are making a ton of money. I'm not going to lie. $3,000. We're making less than before. But we did just spend $1,500 on research. And we spent quite a bit on building all this stuff over here. But this one does seem quite a bit easier than the previous one. I'm not gonna lie, it does seem a little bit easier than the first one that we had going there. Let's also enable priority passes for Rocktopus 12. I should really start naming all of these rides, because right now they've just got horrible names like Rocktopus 12. You know, I don't know why necessarily Rocktopus 12. Why couldn't they just have had Rocktopus? Can I put this down? Oh, I can't put it here. If I move these guys, although they put them down as like individual things, so I can't move all of them as a whole, I don't think, which is actually really annoying. So you know what? I guess we can't really do that. So we'd have to put it like right there, which would be horrific to try and get to. Yeah, I guess that's not gonna work. All right. Well, in that case, let's just disable priority passes. There we go. All right. Can we get rid of this? Control Z. Yeah, there we go. All right. Rocktopus 12 is back open with no priority pass because we can't fit it in because of this horrible pathing that I've done and the horrible placing of these guys in red. But they are increasing the scenery rating, and I think probably driving quite a few people to get on these rides as well, which is pretty good. So we got $18,000 or $19,000 in the bank. We're almost there on the compressed air swinging into action, which is great. How are people feeling about the park in general? Overview, that litter is disgusting. Cosmic Cow Milkshakes is like full or something. Look at this. The GUI is like way too big now. Cosmic Cow Milkshakes 3 looks busy. I'll try somewhere else. I'm not queuing that long to get on the Kraken's Lair. I mean, gosh, the queue is actually still ridiculously long. What happens if we reduce the wait time or the departure interval to 0 seconds? We just set it off over and over and over again. And actually, you know what? What happens if we just bump the speed up to like 10 miles an hour? You know, so it makes the ride a bit faster and hopefully we can get more people going quicker. And also, while we're here, what's the scenery rating like for this? 100%. People love the scenery around this area. That is fantastic. People are thirsty, which I guess is fine. You know what? We'll throw down like another area over here. I was hoping we'd have like not a Cosmic Cow Milkshake, but you know what? Here we go. Boom. Another Cosmic Cow Milkshake and boom, another hot dog squad. That does mean people, it kind of goes against the flow of the park because people have to walk backwards into what is the exit for Rocktopus to get to these areas, but that's fine. And we did also finish our research here. So let's go ahead, let's have a look. With your research, we have unlocked the hammer swing. All right, continue. Where can we put down the hammer swing? Whoa, this thing is pretty big. Maybe like here? Yeah, you know, we'll put it there and then we'll have people walk like around here and then exit back around and out and kind of connect up over here maybe. And hopefully that will be like, all right. So you know what, we'll put the entrance right there. We'll put the exit, hopefully, kind of just right about. Can I place the exit, please? Oh, I can't put it there. So I guess we'll put it like right there. And then hopefully we can just do something like this. Again, we'll make the path nice and long and just bring it round and around and then see about connecting it up to this if we could. I guess, ooh, I don't want it to go up. Let's undo that. Can we bring it, like maybe, ooh, we can't really go over those rocks. You know what, let's bring it back a bit and let's see about going out, up a little bit, and then like around, still, it's too high. It's too high, it went too high. Around and around and then up. No, we can't go up. What is this? This is horrible. This is actually horrible. Can we not? Oh, okay. Let me go back a little bit. Let's see about bringing it down from here. Like that. No, that's not going to work. What is this? What? What is this monstrosity? Let's go out and around. Get rid of some of these. And then maybe down from here? This is not at all what I wanted. I don't want it to connect to that. That's not what I want. Oh my goodness. This is okay. Back to the drawing board. We're gonna get rid of this. Undo. We're gonna bring that back a little bit. And you know what? We're gonna connect it up over here. Perfect. There we go. So not quite as continuous as I would like, but once you get off this, you do still have to walk back around and kind of through all this area here if you want to leave the park. And so in theory, it kind of worked out all right. And then over here, let's bring this down a little bit, try and get it onto ground level so that we can bring it along over and try and connect it to this, which it doesn't seem to want to do. Let me undo a little bit. Can we have it come off here? It doesn't look like we can actually. Oh, that's okay, that's fine. We'll just have it come off here. So this is a pretty long queue again, which is not the best. We are gonna have to spend a little bit on making it look nice because it is a ridiculously long queue, but that is the second objective complete. And now all we need to do is try and get 1,000 people into the park, which should be fairly easy to do with a little bit of marketing. So how is this ride's current queue? It's 63%, which is not bad, but could definitely be improved. So let's have a look. Blueprints, it looks like we really only have pirate stuff for now. So you know what? We'll throw down this lovely like stage with pirates on it right there. And on the opposite side, we'll have like this. Look at that. Beautiful. It's just a standalone cannon firing itself. That brings the queue rating up to 100%. It probably has like the best queue in the park right now, alongside, I guess, the Kraken's Lair over here. But there we go. That's 5 rides complete. So now everyone's going to get on this ride. How much are we charging for this thing? We are charging $6.50. Nope, we're charging $10. $10 to get on this big swinging hammer. Currently, we have 738 people in the park. So let's go to marketing. Let's start a new marketing campaign. And I feel like we should probably market towards either adults or teenagers. Let's look at overview here. If we look at guests, we can see who's spending the most money on roller coasters. So it looks like teens and adults are definitely spending the most, with adults, I guess, slightly outpacing teens. They're spending a little bit more on food, a little bit more on drink, a little bit less on rides, although the teens are also dropping there. So maybe a little bit more on rides for adults. Yeah, you know what? We will market this towards adults. So we'll go back over. Marketing. Let's start a new marketing campaign. Let's go with a late night talk show. It's going to cost us $5,000, but it should bring in a ton of adults into our park. Look at this thing. We've transformed it from a park that was killing people to a park that is probably still going to kill somebody at some point. But for the time being, doing pretty fine. While we're waiting for that to go up, let's see if I can extend this path around and make a semi-decent looking circle. If I kind of bring this around like this and like this. I've been trying my hardest to build circles in a single player world, and they always end up looking kind of like this circle, a little bit odd. You know, it's not terrible, but it's kind of terrible. It's not the best looking circle in the world, and they always end up with this little bump at the top there as well, which is a little bit annoying. But at this point, it's pretty much a waiting game. We've still got massive queues for this over here. So you know what? We're going to bump the price of this up back to $24 because the queue is just far too long. It might have been a mistake to put down an entertainer and the Cosmic Cam Hookshake right here because it is just clogging up massively. This path could definitely do with being quite a bit wider. Unfortunately, I don't think there's a way to increase the width once it's been placed down, because you can place these really big paths that go like 10 blocks wide. Like if I show you this here, this thing is huge, but you can't upgrade existing paths to be massive, which is what I'd like to do. I'd like to make this really big going along here, but there we go. We did it. Creature Awakens. We now have 1,012 people in our park. The achievement unlocked when we got 1,001. Cash in the bank, just shy of 25,000. Most popular attraction is Forge 2, which surprises me. I feel like it's the Kraken's Lair over here, which is making us the big money because there were so many people queuing up for it. Although I guess Forge 2 is quite the thrill ride, being above... Oh my goodness, look at this. That's disgusting. Being above those tentacles in the floor there. But with that, guys, I'm going to end this episode of Planet Coaster there. As always, if you did enjoy the video, episode, hit like. It really does help out a lot. Next time, we'll come back and we'll continue on with part 3 to the Pirate's Kingdom. Let me go ahead and save this real quick. We'll save the park as, what did we call it last time? YouTube 1. We'll call this YouTube 2, and we'll save the park there. What is the next one? Because there's one more inside of Captain Lockjaw's pirate section, and then after that, we move on to the next bit. So we do have... Pirate's Cove is the next one we'll come back to. I think we have reached level 2. We have almost level 3. So we can actually almost get into Dexar's Science Shenanigans. We can almost get to there as well at level 3. We might actually get to level 3 after we complete this one. So we could probably just skip the princess entirely. But we won't. We'll go through. We'll play through these. And we'll see how well we can do. But like I said, guys, thank you for watching. And I will see you next time.